السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. A man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and requested him to teach him surahs from the Quran to read. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, read three surahs which start with Alif Lam Ra, such as Surah Yusuf and Surah Hud and Surah Yunus, or Surah Al-Hijr, any surah, any three surahs that start with Alif Lam Ra. And the man said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kaburat sinni wa ishtadda qalbi wa ghaluza lisani. He said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, I am getting old and it's difficult for me to read any of these three surahs, and my tongue will not help me do that. And the Prophet ﷺ said, then three surahs from Hamim, which start with Hamim, such as Surah Ghafir, Surah Al-Dukhan, Surah Fussilat. And the man said to the Prophet ﷺ the same thing. I'm getting old and it looks like tough for me to do that. And the Prophet ﷺ said, then three from the Musabbihat, yani three surahs that start with tasbih, such as Surah Al-Hashr and Surah Al-Saff, and maybe Surah Al-A'la or Surah Al-Hadid, any of these surahs that start with the tasbih. And the man said to the Prophet ﷺ the same thing. I'm getting old, it's difficult for me, I will not be able to do it. But he said to him, O Messenger of Allah, can you just teach me one surah that will gather all this, that will give me the comprehensive reward of reading all these surahs? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَلَهَا, Surah Al-Zalzalah. He taught him Surah Al-Zalzalah. And the man said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَاللَّهِ لَا أَزِيدُ عَلَيْهَا, by Allah, I'm not going to add any other surahs. I'm going to just read this surah, Surah Al-Zalzalah. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ يَصْدُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. When the man said this, I'm not going to read any other surah except this one. Then the Prophet, and the man left. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about this man, "Aflahar ruwaijilu, aflahar ruwaijil." This man had achieved success. This man had achieved success. Yani, this is a sufficient honor for this surah, Surah Al-Zalzalah. When you look at the surah and you see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes one of the greatest scenes and one of the greatest major signs of the Day of Judgment, when Israfil alayhi salatu wasalam blows the trumpet the first time and the earth shakes with its final earthquake and throws out everything. أَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said in his hadith, تَقِيءُ الْأَرْضُ أَفْلَادَ أَكْبَادِهَا, the earth will throw out the pieces of its lever. And he meant what? He meant the columns of gold and silver, like, and everything will come out. And the man who used to stop the people and rob them and kill them for the sake of money, he will come and look at this gold and silver and say, I have committed all the sins because of this. And the man who used to steal from the people will come and will look at the gold and silver and will say, I used to steal from the people because of this. And the man who killed the people for the sake of the money will come and look at the gold and silver and will say, I killed the people because of this. And all of them will leave it and will not take anything from it. This is according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the dharra in this ayah, in this surah, dharra refers to the smallest thing that you can ever imagine. In the Arabic language, they used to liken the word dharra. When they use the word dharra, they used to always think of an ant, that the dharra is similar to the ant. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever acts or does something good which is equal to that small size of the thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him for that. And whoever does something bad still will get the punishment according to that action, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives his sins. When this ayah was recited to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, لَا أُبَالِي أَلَّا أَسْمَعَ غَيْرَهَا. He said, I will not listen to anything else except this one. I will not, like in other words, I will not mind if I don't listen to anything except this ayah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, upon listening to this ayah, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى. I will not mind if I don't listen to anything else except this ayah, because it explains everything. Subhanallah, the earth will come on the day of judgment and will inform and will talk and will be one of the witnesses. Allah says in this surah, يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. يَوْمَئِذٍ, on the day of judgment, the earth will speak up and will say and will tell whatever happened on it of good and bad. Whatever happened on it of the crimes and the sins, and whatever happened on it of goodness and things that are beneficial to the people. Whatever happened on it of the ibadat, the worship, every single spot that we pray on will come on the day of judgment and will witness for the person. يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith, لَا يَسْمَعُ صَوْتَ الْمُؤَذِّنِ جِنٌ وَلَا إِنْسٌ وَلَا شَيْءٌ إِلَّا شَهِدَ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Not a single creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that hears the voice of the adhan, whether it is a jinn, mankind, whatever it is, but will come as a witness on the day of judgment. So the entire earth and what it has will come as a witness on the day of judgment. And nas, the people on the day of judgment, will be resurrected according to this surah. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَصْدُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ. People will be resurrected on the day of judgment in groups, and they will walk in flocks, in delegations, in groups. Each and every group knows exactly where it is going, to Jannah or to the hellfire. Allah says in the Quran, يَوْمَ نَحْشُرُ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِلَى الرَّحْمَنِ وَفْدًا وَنَسُوقُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدًا. On the day of judgment, we will resurrect the pious, the righteous, and will lead them to Jannah in group, in delegation. And the mushrikeen, al-mujrimeen, the criminals, will be driven to the fire, and they will be thirsty. وَنَسُوقُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in the Quran, يَوْمَ تَجِدُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مُحْضَرًا. On the day of judgment, every single person will find what he or she has forwarded for themselves. Allah says in the hadith Qudsi, Ya ibadi, innama hiya a'malukum uhsiha lakum thumma uwaffikum ilayya iyyaha. These are your actions and your deeds. I count them for you. And in the day of judgment, you will see the result. Whoever sees something good should be thankful, grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever sees something else should blame himself only. And this surah encourages us to do every single good thing and to stay away from every single bad thing. We should not underestimate any goodness that we're doing. And we should not underestimate any evil that we might be committing. Because Allah says in the Quran, وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا. And in the day of judgment, we'll set up the balance, the scales, that will weigh the good deeds against the bad deeds. And no one will be wronged in anything. فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا وَإِنْ كَانَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ أَتَيْنَا بِهَا وَكَفَى بِنَا حَاسِبِينَ. If it is even the smallest part that you can ever imagine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring it up and everything is going to be recorded. So the surah has a lot of meanings and concepts. And we see how the Prophet ﷺ encouraged this man to read it and encourages every Muslim to read it and to reflect, to have a deep reflection over the meaning of this surah. We have a beautiful example from our imams, our great scholars. Imam Abu Hanifa, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be merciful to him. He prayed Salat al-Isha behind an imam. And the imam was reading in Salat al-Isha, Surah al-Zalzala. إِذَا زُلْزِلَةِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَلَهَا. And people finished the prayer. The imam left and everyone else left. And only the muadhin was waiting for Imam Abu Hanifa to leave. And Imam Abu Hanifa was sitting after the prayer and was reflecting on this surah and on these ayat. And he used to say, يَا مَنْ يَجْزِي بِمِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا وَيَجْزِي وَيَا مَنْ يَجْزِي بِمِثْقَالِ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا أَجِرِ النُّعْمَانَ عَبْدَكَ مِنَ النَّارِ وَأَدْخِلْهُ سِعَةَ رَحْمَتِكَ. He used to say this, O Allah, the one who rewards according to the smallest good deed and the one who punishes according to the smallest bad deed. Protect your servant and Nu'man from the hellfire and admit him into your mercy. He is sitting with deep reflection on the surah and the muadhin is waiting and there is only very small amount of oil left in the lamp. And the muadhin finally, he did not want to disturb him. He left the masjid, went home, and the imam was sitting in his place. The entire night was sitting in the same spot, just reflecting over these two ayahs. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. And did not pay attention to anyone. When he was in such deep reflection, he did not pay attention to anyone. And it was the first time the muadhin came, opened the masjid, and luckily the lamp still was still like providing them with the light. There is still some light in there. And then when Imam Abu Hanifa saw him, he thought that is this still the time after Isha, and he asked the muadhin, oh, are you planning to turn it off so we can leave? He said, yeah, Imam, it is the Fajr time. Can you imagine? Subhanallah, it is the Fajr time. And subhanallah, the Imam Abu Hanifa said to muadhin, never ever tell anyone about this. Someone might say, so how did we know the story? Yes, you don't tell about the person during his lifetime. So as to keep it secret between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But khalas, the person after Abu Hanifa passed away, so this muadhin told the people about this story in order to give them the encouragement how this great imam used to reflect over the verses and the surahs and the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sitting the entire night just reflecting over these two ayats. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. And that will teach us a lesson. When we enjoy our ibadah, when we enjoy our reflection over Allah's verses and over Allah's revelation, when we enjoy our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will not feel the passage of the time. The imam was sitting down the entire night, didn't feel the passage of the time until the muadhin came the second morning. Subhanallah. Yani, this is a surah that I wanted to, inshallah, yani, share with you how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam yani speaks highly about it and how he encourages the people to read this surah. And when he said, when the man said, I will never add any surah to this one, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the man had achieved success, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not mean that we will restrict ourselves to reading only this surah. But he means to encourage the person. And if you don't have time to read a long surah, recite, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ يَصْدُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى ومن العمل ما ترضى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا واشرح صدورنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك آمالنا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البرص والجذام ومن الجنون وسيء الأسقام. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك ومن تحول عافيتك ومن فجاءة نقمتك ومن جميع سخطك يا الله يا كريم. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.